Welcome back to our channel. Here I am with a new content on microscopy. I started to make videos on microscopes. I suggest you to have a look on those. Few of them are earlier videos with disturbed sound quality though. Please bear with that. Do not forget to share your comments, any suggestions. So let's learn. From the thumbnail, you could recognize this method of microscopy. This method is useful in TEM, that is transmission electron microscopy. In this video, I try to discuss about SEM versus TEM, and this video could be beneficial for understanding. So please watch it before. Today we are going to learn what is freeze fracture technique, basic steps of this method, and finally modified form of this method, that is freeze etching. We already know cell membrane consists of phospholipids and attached or embedded proteins. Membrane proteins play vital roles in the metabolism and life of the cell. You cannot use ordinary microscope to visualize or characterize adhesion proteins. Using freeze fracture technique in electron microscope, it is possible to split frozen cell membrane apart, allows visualization of the membrane structure and the organization of proteins within the sea of phospholipids. This method is beneficial for the visualization and detailed analysis of the function of specific proteins, bacteria, and viruses. Using liquid nitrogen, biological tissue samples or cells are rapidly frozen to immobilize cell constituents. Now it is cracked on a plane through the tissue by cleaving it with a microtome knife. This fracture occurs along weak portions of the tissue, as in hydrophobic lipid tails are weakest point. Following the fracturing step, the sample undergoes a vacuum procedure called freeze etching. The surface of the sample is shadowed with carbon and platinum vapor to make stable replica, which follows the contours of the fracture plane. Acids like nitric, sulfuric, and chromic acids are used to digest organic material adhering to the replica. It leaves a thin platinum shell of the fractured membrane structure, and this shell is then analyzed by electron microscope. This is a slight modification of freeze fracture technique. It is a vacuum drying of an unfixed frozen and freeze fracture biological sample. The vacuum drying procedure is similar to freeze fracture fruits and vegetables. Without freeze etching, many details of cellular structures are obscured by ice crystals. Etching exposes the true surfaces of freeze fracture membranes, thereby revealing membrane surface features of interest that were obscured previously by the overlying ice. The frozen fractured specimen is exposed to a vacuum at an elevated temperature for 1 to a few minutes, during which a layer of ice can evaporate from the exposed surface. Once some of the ice has been removed, the surface of the structure can be coated with heavy metal and carbon to create metallic replica. It allows for the analysis of not only the membrane structure but also of intracellular components and provides detailed structural information on bacteria, viruses, and large cellular protein complexes. This is all about today's video, learners. Hope this will be helpful. I read these books and specially sciencing.com for making this video. Thank you for your patience.